again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know, tell them I won't be long.
Hi Nan, I am sure you are now in a better place and a more peaceful setting, with Harry on one side and Nanny Redpath on the other. I hope you have lots of cream for your coffee. I am sure God has made provisions for that. I can't help but think of the day you gave me permission to take care of your lovely daughter. That was, I guess, the highlight of my life, and it has improved ever since. God has given us 3 great children and 2 grandchildren, and we are thankful for that.
Maybe it's because I'm a Londoner that I love London so. Well, maybe it's because I'm a Londoner that I think of her wherever I go. I get a funny feeling inside of me while walking up and down. Well, maybe it's because I'm a Londoner that I love the London town.
Nan, you have always told me that when your mom passed away, God gave me to you to love. Nan, you were the pillar of our family, and you were a wonderful grandmother, and we will love you always and speak of you often.
Oh, she's been there. God knows she's been there. She has seen and done it all. 'Cause she's a woman and she knows how to dish it out or take it all. Her heart's as soft as feathers. Still she weathers stormy skies, and she's a sparrow. She's broken, but she's an eagle when she flies.
For those people that were close to you, Mum, and knew you well, you will always be known as the person that when someone asked you how you are, you always said, "I am the better for seeing you." And you meant that with the utmost of sincerity. I'll carry your legacy on, and I promise from now on when people ask me how I am, I will reply, "I am all the better for seeing you."
Nan, you always displayed great work ethics and moral ethics. You respected other people and their thoughts, and you earned their respect in return. This is evident from the close friends that you have acquired while at the Mental Health Center, Burkeville Protestant Separate School, the Anglican Parish of Penetanguishene, and the public at large. You might have been stricken by that terrible disease, Alzheimer's, but you won't be remembered by its effects, but by the long and caring manners you displayed as a wife, mother, mother-in-law, grandmother, and great-grandmother.
Down and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence. sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
I give you this one thought to keep. I am with you still, I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints in the snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift uplifting rush of quiet birds in circled flight. I am the soft stars that shine at night. I do not think of me as gone. I am with you still in each new dawn.
You reached out to so many people in many different ways. Heaven's gain is our loss, but you have left us with so many memories that we can reminisce forever. Your loving son-in-law, David.
With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. Just the song at the start, but it soon is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand. It tells that you're standing near and at the sound of your voice.
Heaven with Dad and Granddad Charlie and Nanny Ripa. We will miss you and you will forever be in our hearts. I remember when Dad talked about coming to Canada and you were so hesitant to do so, but finally gave in and you made Canada your home. You became a proud Canadian and yet always remained faithful to the British Isles. And I know your favorite poem is what I'm going to read to you now. This royal throne of kings, this sceptered isle, this earth of majesty, this seat of Mars, this other Eden, demi-paradise, this fortress built by nature for herself against infection and the hand of war, this happy breed of men, this little world, this precious stone set in the silver sea, which serves it in the office of a wall, or as a moat defensive to of a house, against the envy of less happier lands, this blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this England. I know you love that, Mum. Goodbye. You'll never be forgotten. Love you, Lynn.